Good afternoon, everyone. Okay, thank you for having me here. As you know, my name is Nicola Toccato. I'm a PhD student from the University of Padova. And on behalf of my colleagues from the university and from Mitsubishi Electric Laboratories, I'm going to present the approach that we implemented for solving the tasks of this threatening intelligence challenge. So this is the outline of this presentation. First, I will give a very brief overview of the channel, of the challenge, since it was already covered. I will be very brief. Then I will give an explanation and some insights over the model-based reinforcement learning algorithm that we used for the challenge. Then we show the main results of the two stages of the competition, and finally I will draw some conclusions. Okay, so the challenge is considers two degrees of freedom robot under the effect of gravity in the two different configurations that were already explained, the pendulum and the acrobat. And the goal of the challenge is to develop a controller for the swing up and stabilization in the upright position of both both systems in a simulation and in a real state. And in each stage there is a performance and robustness score that evaluates the controller. Okay. Overview finished, so I do not complete my slide.
Put this. Okay. Okay. Now we will present a high level view over the model-based reinforcement learning algorithm that we exploited to solve the tasks of the challenge. So the algorithm is MCPILCO, which stands for Monte Carlo Probabilistic Inference for Learning Control. It is a policy gradient algorithm, which is particularly suited for and thought for mechanical systems. So the architecture of the algorithm is very classical for model-based reinforcement learning algorithms. It is composed of an outer loop with the three main stages: the interaction with the system, a model learning phase, and a policy update, and then there is an iteration of these three phases. I will give a very brief explanation of the notation and assumptions that are done for the algorithm. So the state of the system XT is composed of the robot's joints position and velocities. The control input UT is completely determined by a policy function parameterized by some parameters called the theta. We have a local cost function that encodes the requirements of the task, and I will just show at the end what it means. And the final goal of the algorithm is to minimize this cumulative cost with respect to the parameters of the policy, starting from an initial state distribution. So a little bit more in detail, what it does, the algorithm. If we assume that we can express the system evolution as a function of inputs, the state of the system, and the outputs of the policy function, then we can rewrite the objective of the algorithm as this optimization problem, which is the minimization of this objective function, j of theta, which is the expectation of the cumulative cost with respect to the parameters of the policy. Okay. In the model learning phase, what we do is that we exploit this very, very simple state transition model, which encodes the evolution of the state of the system in terms of velocity and positions of the joints as functions these two quantities, which are the delta, the velocity delta, so the change in velocity, so proportion that are proportional to the acceleration of the system. So what the model learning phase does is that it exploits Gaussian process regression in order to learn these velocity deltas directly from data. So a Gaussian process is a regression model that that uses a prior mean function and a covariance function to get a posterior distribution over the regression problem. I won't go in detail over Gaussian process regression. What I just need to say is that we need to define a prior mean function and a covariance function, which is a kernel function that expresses the correlation between data points. So basically, the prior mean is a model that we have over the system, and I will show what it means in reality. Basically, what the Gaussian process regression do is that it learns the residuals over this prior mean function. So, by applying Gaussian process regression to the state transition model, we can get this one step ahead stochastic model, which is a probability distribution over a state xt plus one conditioned by the prior state xt and the past state and past control input ut. The policy update phase exploits a stochastic gradient descent approach to optimize the policy parameters. So in the previous slide, what I said is that we want to optimize the cost g of theta, but actually the J of theta is not possible to obtain in closed form using the one step ahead model that is written at the bottom of the slide. So the solution that is used by MC Pilco is a Monte Carlo approximation, from which the Monte Carlo at the beginning of the name. So what we do at each step of the gradient descent is that we sample a batch of particles from the initial distribution, and then we simulate the evolution of these particles under the control of the current policy using this one step ahead stochastic model. Since it is a stochastic model, there is a distribution, and each time we sample from that distribution. Okay, once we have simulated the horizon over the particles over the horizon, we can compute this approximation of J of theta, and from this approximation of the final cost, we can backpropagate the gradient to update the policy parameters. Okay, this was the algorithm at a very high level overview. And these are this is the setup that we used to solve the simulation phase of the challenge. So as initial state distribution, we use a simple zero mean normal random variable with a very small variance, just to say that the initial state is at the bottom configuration, and as a cost function to encode the task requirements. So the system needs to go to the swing up. We use a very simple saturated distance, and what this means is that this cost is equal to very very close to one if the state is far from the target configuration, and it is close to zero instead if it is close to the configuration. Instead for the Gaussian process regression, the prior mean function that we used is the acceleration from forward dynamics model times the sampling time. And instead for the kernel function, we used a very, very standard squared exponential kernel. Okay. The policy function that we exploited in the simulation phase is a very simple radial basis function network, which you can think of it as just a one-layer neural network. Notice that we have an activation function which keeps the output of the policy within the correct range. And in red, I highlighted the parameters that are subject to the optimization. We used this policy with a maximum with conservative maximum torques in order to get good scores. For the Pendobot, we used 2.5 Newton meters as maximum torque, and instead for the Acrobot, it is 3. And the algorithm was applied to the simulation with the episodes of length of 3 seconds and the different control frequencies for the two robots, 100 Hz for the Pendobot and 50 Hz for the Acrobot. So what this means is that each time the policy is applied to the system, it is applied for 3 seconds with those control frequencies and so on. Okay, so these are the results of the simulation phase. The scores are the ones that you have already seen in the leaderboard. What I have to add is just that we reached the score of the Pendobot after about 12 episodes, so 10 iterations of the loop, and instead for the Acrobot we needed about 10 episodes. What I have to add, okay, just one last thing about the results is that in the simulation we do the swing up with the policy trained with MCPILCO, but the stabilization is achieved with an LQR controller when the robot reaches the top. Okay. This is just the plot of the strategy of the Pendobot controller. So we can see that the swing up is performed in about 1.5 seconds. What I wanted to highlight is that to reach the swing up, so a configuration where the cost is low, the controller first has to reach a configuration in which the cost is very high in order to collect enough energy for the swing up and then to stabilize with the LQR. Okay. To solve the tasks on the two robots in the real hardware stage, what we did is that we started from the setup that we used in the simulation phase, and this is what we changed. So to account for any actuation delays that is present in the motors, what we did is that we treated the model learning problem as almost a black box, so meaning that we added up to 3 past control inputs to the input of the Gaussian process regression. And by doing this, we were not able anymore to use the prior mean function in the model. So as prior mean function, we used just uniformly zero function. So the dynamics of the model are learned completely black box by the Gaussian process regression. And since for the real hardware there are state constraints that causes the experiment to fail if you go outside the boundaries, we had to penalize this configuration, so we just applied some very, very simple penalties in the cost functions. We were also allowed to use some friction compensation method over the robots, so over the free joints of the robots. So what we did is that instead of using a single radial basis function network as a policy, we used a dual radial basis function for each radial basis function network for each joint. And for the free joint, we used a maximum torque of 0.5 Newton meters, while for the control joint, we used the full 5 Newton meters that were available. And finally, with this setup, we applied the algorithm with episodes of 4 seconds length and control frequency of 33 Hz for both robots. Okay, the these are the results you already see in this course, and in this case we managed to perform both the swing up and stabilization on each robot, and we needed about 8 episodes for the Pendubot and 10, maybe some less for the Acrobot. Okay. This is the strategy that the Aura controller has applied for the Pendubot. What I want you just to notice is that if you look at the angle plot, it is close to what it does, what it did in the simulation phase. So this is something worth noticing. And another thing that I wanted just to point out, this is a weakness of our approach, is that since we observed that the sampling time in the control loop, in the first iterations of the control loop, is not very stable, what we had to do in order to use our policy is to not apply control inputs for the first just the first samples of the control loop. So we lost 0.3 seconds for the swing up, so this is a weakness just of our approach. Okay. Anyways, to conclude the presentation, we managed to solve the task for both systems in both stages. We reached the best performance scores of the simulation leaderboard, and we did very good in for the real hardware stage, reaching the best scores of the Pendubot leaderboard and the best swing up times of the Acrobot leaderboard. As I've stated, I hope clearly here our approach is not perfect, but I think we did very good, and I thank you so much for the attention and for having me here and for organizing this competition.